So one of the things that I started doing, I got the idea from Anson Dorrance, the women's soccer coach at North Carolina, who's won like 20 national championships, is I have winners and losers in every drill that I do. I did this last season. I did this with JV high school girls who just really weren't very good. But we have winners and losers for every drill that we did during practice, with the exception of just pure shooting, like form shooting drills. So the only drills that we didn't have a winner and loser. And then some kind of layup drills we didn't as well. But any kind of team situation like this, we'd have a winner and loser. And I kept track, and I had points. So if you won, you got a point. If you lost, you didn't get a point. We had daily winners. And so I basically made up that at the end of practice, we were going to condition every day. And so the winners, the daily winner, didn't have to do the conditioning. And so conditioning for us was like running like one lap or something like that. So it was just, you know, a token punishment, basically. Didn't really mean that much. But I just wanted the winning to have some sort of consequence. But the other thing that I did is every game, like I played, I had 12 girls. I played all 12 girls every half, unless they were in trouble. And I determined my starting lineup by whoever the top five winners at that point were. So the five who started the season were different than the five who ended the season. My best player, probably my best player, didn't start probably our last 7 or 8 games because she went on vacation during Christmas break and missed like 6 practices. So she missed, you know, 30, 40 points, and she just never could make it up, you know, in the rest of the season. So she didn't start for most of the rest of the season. So I didn't punish her for missing practice. She just didn't have points, so she couldn't start. You know, and as we got to the end of the season and we were kind of fighting for first place, a couple of them, especially her, were like, you know, you need to restart the points, you know, so we can, you know, basically without saying it, get our better players in the starting lineup. And one of the other girls who that would have benefited was like, no, we're not doing that. It's what it is, which I was happy about. So the way it worked out, I think 10 of the 12 girls started during the year, you know, based on that system. So I don't know, it's just something I did. But I really liked the keeping track of points and keeping winners.